How do you find an existing Geant4 simulation in a system where you're just a normal user?
We can use the Geant4 config command to find out everything. Type in Geant4 and press the tab key in your terminal. If you can see three options showing up there, it means that the Geant4 binary directory has been added into your path. Run Geant4 config, and you can see things that you can use. So if you put help here, you see all the features that is enabled or not enabled in your version of Geant4. And you're going to see more things that you can use to find out the Geant4 installation in your system. For example, version. Another thing I always like is the check datasets. If you do not use the automatic way to install all the datasets, or you have some old datasets there, you just want to update some of them, you want to make sure that your datasets are all up to date. So what do? You use this one, check datasets. So we do Geant4 config and check datasets. You're going to see that whether they are installed or not.
Geant4 config is really convenient.
However, you can only use it in Linux and Mac, not in Windows. The other thing is that you can list all the environment variables and search for the one that is related to Geant4. In my case, it's basically all about the Geant4 datasets. For this two method to work, you will have to have the Geant4 binary directory already in your path. If the administrator did not add this one into your path, then you're out of luck to use Geant4 config. So what can you do? If you understand the structure of Linux and the structure of Geant4, you may be able to guess it. In the Linux system, most probably you're going to find many versions of Geant4 in some directory called user local. So let's just check it. We go to user local and ls and check what's in it. Indeed, you find a few Geant4 folders here. So let's just go inside and check what's inside. So there are two versions, 0.9 and 0.10. Let's check Geant4 10. Yes, this is a standard directory structure. We have the bin, we have the three files inside, we have include, we have all the headers here. Then we have lib, we have all the shared libraries here. Then we have share, we have the data there. Okay, this is how I found an existing Geant4 installed in my system without asking anybody. You probably know in your collaboration who does a lot of Geant4 simulation. You can go to his or her home directory and do a search as well. You may be able to find another Geant4 version installed by another person. Another scenario that is possible to happen is that you ask somebody who used Geant4 but does not understand how Geant4 is provided to his or her environment, because that user can already run Geant4, so Geant4 bin directory must be already inside his or her environment variable. In that case, you go back to the first route, that is try to run Geant4 config in that user's terminal to find out the thing that you need. There's another way, that is to use CMake. We know from the compilation of Geant4 that we can use CMake to set up the compilation system for Geant4. And this is true also for all the Geant4 official examples. Let's go to a Geant4 official example. And let's just go to the basic part. Let's go to the first one. And you can see that there is a CMake list.txt. That is a configuration file used by CMake to set up the compilation, and then you can use make to make everything. CMake has a way to find out whether there is a Geant4 installed in your system. How? CMake will search all the lib directory or lib64 directory to see if there's any file called geant4config.cmake. If CMake can find that file, CMake will use information provided in that file to link to your Geant4 installation. Let's go to, for example, the lib64 directory in my home directory. In the lib64 Geant4 version directory, there is a file called geant4config.cmake. So the CMake system will try to find this file in all the lib64 directories. Once it finds one, it will use it. Even if this thing is not in your LD library path, CMake will still search for it. That's an automatic process, so you don't have to know where your Geant4 is installed. Okay, so let's try that. We follow the standard procedure. We make a directory called build. Then we cd into it, and then we run ccmake. The source code is up in the parent directory. So let's run it, and we do a config. You can see that the CMake process already found where the Geant4 is installed in my system, right here. Let's change the file name from lib64 to something else and then run this thing again, see if the CMake process can identify it or not. So let's quit from here. Change lib64 to lib6. Just do an experiment and see what will happen. Come back here, run ccmake config. You can see that it found an old Geant4 installation in the user local lib64. I guess CMake will find the first one that is available. But just in case that you don't know where the Geant4 is, this is a great way for you to find out. And then you figure out that, oh, most probably the Geant4 is in a user local directory. So you go there and you check it, you're gonna find a few there. So let's quit. And we remove everything here. Just clean it up, clear it up. Okay, let's change this one back to 64. And then we come back here and we do a ccmake and config. No wonder I found the latest Geant4 installed in my home directory.